So now coming back to your sales and services of your company, and so what are the common spare parts you used to sell, and what are the customer used to come for you on a particular, what are the most commonly used spare parts?
See, commonly used spare parts are brake wires, brake levers, brake shoes, and another smaller thing which people are not taking very serious is the brake switch.
Okay.
Every vehicle is fitted with a brake switch, which stops the vehicle before mechanical brake. That what it means is whenever you brake,
okay,
the running motor will get stopped first, and then it will stop the mechanical brake.
Okay.
So that is the most important. The people has to check with this electric brakes, which makes the motor and controller failure of because of this brake switch.
Okay.
It is a very small switch. It not cost more than 50 rupees.
Okay.
So people, they are disconnected whenever the brake switch get fails.
Mm-hmm.
Instead of changing complete brake unit, they'll disconnect the brake switch.
Mm.
But it is not correct. Whenever it is failed, definitely you have to replace the switch either, or you have to replace the complete brake unit. That is the most important. And another things, most of the times the controller will get fail, controller connectors will get fail. What you can see that yellow box, if you can show me this. This is the connector box which is connected to the controller.
Okay.
Most of the time this will get
disconnected
or sparks, something will get wrong because of overload on the motor.
Okay.
Overload on the motor, the wires connected to this connector will get burned.
Mm.
So that is also the cause where most of the time this has to be replaced. And other brake levers are there, most controllers are there, throttles are there, ignition keys are there. These are all the common spare parts what we sell every day.
Can you please explain in brief, like what are the basic prices for each and every part?
Total what we sell, we have the lowest cost from 150 rupees to 650 rupees.
Okay.
And brake cables, they are from 100 to 150, 200. Different models of different sizes of brake cables have a different ranges.
Okay.
And tires, tubes, switches, ignition switches, indicator switches, headlight switches, all this comes around 50 to 100 rupees. What higher costlier is a controller,
okay,
which will cost you around 2500 to 3500 rupees depending upon the wattage and voltage of the controller. Okay.
So this is what I want to ask something, I think whether you can answer it or not. Like, what are the regularly you will receive some kind of complaints about some particular, you are actually you are dealing with the spare parts, right? So what are the most common electric scooter that you get face problem with, and that you going to replace with the spare parts?
Most common, or that is what I am saying, is the controller, throttle.
All
electric scooters have a common complaints.
Common complaints on
controllers and throttles. Throttles, generally they will get brake because of mishandling, that is the main problem. And controllers, we have different type of controllers. Now it has come with the sine wave controllers also.
Okay.
It is very good one, but most of the cases these controllers will fail only because of this. That is what I have said, so told you, is without using the brake switches.
Okay.
And if there is any unwanted sound occurs on the motor or in some other places, you have to get repaired, serviced immediately.
Okay.
Because that's meant to bigger problems.
Okay.
That is why this. Another thing is, in the rainy seasons, most of these motors will get water inside the motor, in the deep water. When you run it in a deep water, the motor also, the water can insert into the motor.
But and people are saying it is IP65.
No, it is IP65, but only 85%. 85% motors are IP65, but is not 100% fully waterproof. Customer doesn't know that water has gone inside, and they keep on running the vehicle. And after 1 month or 2 months, that water will get rusted, and it may cause to failure of the motor or motor sensor inside the motor. So, so this is also the common, most of the complaints comes occurs in rainy seasons.
What about the battery pack also? Then such
even battery packs also, I have seen these flooded time year, this year I have seen most of the batteries, even my battery, what I assemble, has got flooded with the water. So that is also main thing you have to look after. All the manufacturer has to check out with this. Everybody has faced with this complaint.
So, but manufacturer used to say they have sealed the battery completely.
They have sealed the batteries, but even then water has come inside. Because of most flooded, you can say if it is the most flooded, and some of the vehicles, see, I cannot want to
brand
the brand. Some of the vehicles base is very lower base.
Okay.
Road gap is very less and the battery is fitted at the
low ground clearance.
When you run in a minimum rainy water also, the back will push the water into the battery pack.
Okay.
So that is the reason why this water is been entering into the battery packs.
Okay.
So it has to be taken care.
Mr. Deepak, you said that you also sell retrofitting kits also. So what could be the price for a two-wheeler conversion kit? And are you providing three-wheeler kits also?
Yes.
So what is the price of it? And will you give the service or they bring the vehicle to you?
So we do supply retrofittings for bicycle, scooter, motorcycles, e-rickshaws, even for four-wheeler conversions also. We have all type of e-bike conversion kits. So these ranges starts from 6,500 to 65,000, 1.5 lakhs also, depending upon the kilowatt of the motor. For four-wheeler, it comes around 75 to 80,000 starting from 2 kilowatt, 18,000 for 1.5 kilowatt, 18,000 to 1.5 lakhs also for
the
four-wheeler conversion.
It purely depends on the motor capacity.
Motor capacity and the type of motor also.
So what will be the, for example, if you want to bring your cycle to you,
yeah.
So you said it will be around 6,500.
From 6,500, starts from 6,500.
So you give the battery pack also with that?
No, battery pack is not included in the retrofitting. Battery packs depends upon the customer's requirement. See, some of the customers, they need only 15 to 20 kilometers range. So they can go for a smaller battery pack that will cost you less.
What can be the price of a 20 kilometer?
20 kilometers battery will be costing you around 3,500 rupees.
So
that is 5.8.
In 10,000 itself, they will get complete then.
Yes, of course. Yes.
So what can be the,
most of the cycles sold in the market is with 5.8 Ah batteries.
Okay.
That will give you not more than 15 to 20, 30 kilometers.
Okay. So what will be the electric three-wheeler? So will you give the do the fitting everything for them?
No, we don't have such facilities. We can provide you technical assistance.
Okay.
We
so
can
we
provide you the technical assistance. You can fit it. We have some other workshops also. My colleagues' workshops are there. You can go and fit it at their place.
Okay.
We can provide you the spare parts and kits. We can provide you.
So
technical, any technical assistance you want in conversion, or you if you want to make some modifications, we can support you.
So my next question to you is, you said that you will provide the retrofitting kits. But as per the government policy, you need to be certified for that. Those retrofitting kits should be certified. So what kind of certified kits you are using?
Presently, most of the kits are not certified. Most of the kits sold in the market are not certified. It has to be get certified from the ICAT or AREI. So most of the kits are not been certified. All are imported from China. And they are selling it, no kits
so
are being certified.
It's not just your case, all the...
Almost all in India, no kits has been retrofittings are certified. Some of the kits are been registered, but most of the kits are not registered. It is not freely available, whichever the kits are been certified, it is not freely available in the market.
Okay.
Most of them are retrofits are sold in the market or without certification.
Okay.
without ARA certification.
So actually this is for our knowledge, like viewers used to have some common doubts, like can they use their vehicle, can they use a retrofitted vehicle without any license?
This I cannot comment because it has to be registered in the RTO.
Electricvehicles.in motto is keeping the earth a safer place to live for the next generations. If you want to join our movement, you can support simply subscribing to our channel or sharing our videos or commenting on videos. Thanks for watching.